Correlation is a measure of how closely related two variables are. So we say two variables are correlated if knowing the value of one variable provides information on the likely value of the other. If this is the case in our data, a plot of one value against the other will have a definite pattern, and we'll see what that pattern is in this exercise. This is what our monthly CO2 data looks like. Column A has the year, column B the months, which are numbered 1 to 12, that means 1's January and 12's December. Columns C to E are different measures of CO2 emissions. So to do this, we're going to use column E, which is trend data, to make a scatter plot that compares CO2 emissions and temperature anomalies for month 1, that's January. To do this exercise, you're going to need to have two spreadsheets open at the same time. The first is the CO2 data that we're looking at, and the other one is the temperature anomaly spreadsheet. Note that some of the data in your project might have been updated, so it won't match what you see on the screen here. Don't worry, all the steps are exactly the same, even if your result might be slightly different. Now, go back to the CO2 data. First, we need to filter it so it shows only January. In Windows, that means you click Sort and Filter in the top right, then Filter, click on the arrow for the month, and you will see the values 1 to 12. Unclick the top box to deselect all of the months, and then just click 1. Hit Enter, and you can see that not all the rows are visible anymore. We're just looking at the data now for January each year. If you're working on a Mac, the box looks a little bit different, so here it is. But as you can see, the process is basically the same. Remember, the data for the other months, it's still there, the filters have just hidden it. Column E has the trend data that we need. Select all the cells in column E, click and drag on the numbers only to highlight them all the way to the bottom of the column. In Windows, Ctrl+C copies that data to the clipboard, and for Mac users, that's Command+C. Now switch to the temperature anomaly data. We need to filter this as well so that the range of years matches. The CO2 data begins in 1959, so we need to filter between 1959 in the top box and 2017 in the bottom box. Here's what it looks like in Windows. And again for our Mac users, here's what it's going to look like for you. The data you just copied should have the same number of rows as the data on the worksheet. Click on the first empty column, level with the first row of numbers, type Ctrl+V in Windows, that's Command+V on a Mac of course, and paste the data. Type a header for the column so that other people can see what your data is, and scroll down just to check that the number of rows matches. I'm going to minimize the CO2 data so that we can concentrate on this spreadsheet, because it's the only one we're going to use from now on. The next thing we're going to do is to make a chart called a scatterplot from the data. First, we need to select the January temperature data and then hold down the Ctrl key, Mac users, that's the Command key, and select the CO2 data as well. Both should be highlighted. If you're not used to doing this, it can be a bit tricky and take a couple of goes at first. Click on the Insert menu on the top left because we're going to insert a chart. In the middle of the toolbar that pops up when you click Insert, there's a gallery of chart types. Pick the scatterplot icon, it has little dots on it, and select the first chart. The basic scatterplot should pop up in the middle of your data. If you were making a report, you'd move it, but let's leave it there for now. At a quick look, it looks like the data's correlated because when CO2 is higher, so is the temperature. But it's not very clear at the moment, and we can make this easier to look at by adjusting the scale of the vertical axis. To do this, position the cursor over the vertical axis, and Windows users, click the right button on the mouse. Mac users, you have to hold down the Ctrl key this time while you click the mouse button. A menu should pop up hovering over the chart. Select Format Axis and click on the Axis Options. The minimum bound is Excel's name for the point at which the vertical axis crosses the horizontal axis. None of our data points are lower than 250, so we can type that into the box. Close the access options box and you will see that the scatter plot is much clearer now. But at the moment, no one else looking at this chart would know what it was. Even you're going to struggle to remember it yourself when you open it up next week. So always, always, always label your chart and both of the axes. To do this, click on the chart, click design, and you'll see placeholders for the axes in the title. We're going to type short titles for speed, but it's always better to be precise. For example, use years, locations, or data sources when you label your charts. Our last step is to calculate the correlation. To do this, we're going to use a statistic called the correlation coefficient. It tells us how close the data is to a straight line on a scatter plot. The correlation coefficient ranges in value from -1 to 1. If the coefficient's 1, then the data is a straight line sloping upwards. And if it's -1, it's a straight line sloping downwards. And if it's 0, then the variables are probably not related to each other. Looking at our scatter plot, we can see something that's a bit like a straight line going upwards, and so we should not expect the correlation to be 0, and we definitely wouldn't expect it to be negative. But Excel offers a formula to calculate the correlation exactly. Select an empty column, label the cell at the top so that we know that the number is the correlation, and in the first blank row, type this formula. Equals, correl, and an open bracket. And now we need the arguments. First, select the temperature anomaly data we're using, which is column B. Add a comma, select the CO2 data, and close the bracket. This is what the formula should look like. You can see how it represents the two data series. You can always type these cell references directly into the formula. So the last thing to do is to see what it's calculated for our correlation. And as you can see, the number is positive and it's close to 1 as we expected. Remember when calculating statistics like this, always check that the outcome seems to match what you see on the chart. It's a simple step to make sure that you haven't accidentally selected the wrong data.